Feel free to check out my TeePublic after the video.
Hello, I'm Daisuke Sato, director of Howl from Beyond the Fog. So enjoy the video.
Last year at G-Fest 25, indie filmmaker Daisuke Sato with famous creature suit maker Keizo Murasi came to showcase her upcoming film funded via Kickstarter, Sagiri no Kuni, also known as Howl from Beyond the Fog. During the event, we got to see a preview as well as props and behind-the-scenes photos of the production, including the head of the film's monster, Nebula. Now, at this year's G-Fest 26, Sato returned to show a 15-minute unfinished version of the film. Back in 2007, Daisuke Sato made a short film based on Ray Bradbury's The Foghorn. Unfortunately, the film got lost in a hard drive crash, according to an interview from Toho Kingdom. Now only images and a trailer exist. While some online sources say that Howl from Beyond the Fog is meant to be a sequel of sorts, Sato claims that the film is its own original creation. Now, I know the film is incomplete, but I can tell you that when it is finished, Howl from Beyond the Fog could honestly be one of the best monster movies out there. I won't give away too many things because the film is still being worked on and some things might get changed along the way, so keep that in mind. From what I could gather, the plot follows a blind girl who is ostracized by the rest of her village and often went to visit the monster Nebula, who kills her brother early in the film. Nebula is a very unique creature on its own. It resembles that of a plesiosaur or your traditional lake monster, as it is also blind and only attacks when it is seen, while also being obscured by fog. Another thing to note is that the characters aren't played by real people, but puppets. More specifically, the film is done in Bunraku mixed with Tokusatsu. This did take a little while for me to adjust to, because I had a feeling the puppetry for the characters would come off as stiff, but their movements were surprisingly fluid and were executed very well. These elements, combined with the lighting and set pieces, make for a rather bleak tone, which is definitely enhanced by the scoring by Chocho, as it gives the film this somber but beautiful atmospheric ambience. Overall, Howl from Beyond the Fog looks like it's going to be a very impressive short film through its mood, tone, and uniqueness compared to other monster and special effects films. For those wondering about the film's completion, director Daisuke Sato plans to have it finished in November. As for a release, there are plans to put the film out for physical media and online for streaming. Those who backed the project through its Kickstarter while it was up will receive the film. In the end, if you're a fan of movies like Godzilla and the Beast from 20,000 Fathoms, I would highly recommend checking out Howl from Beyond the Fog when it is released. That's all I have for this video. Thank you for watching, and I want to give a very special thank you to director Daisuke Sato for not only that sweet introduction, but for presenting what we can expect to be a very beautiful film. Feel free to like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and I'll see you guys later.